There are hundreds of different chemicals in indoor air, but one of the ones that we want to do something about in particular is formaldehyde. It's made up of some really simple molecules that we've all heard of, but when combined together, it's actually quite a harmful pollutant. This space represents a pretty standard bedroom. We've got a double bed in the middle here, a couple of side tables, and we're stood on some lovely wooden flooring. And all of these things are emitting formaldehyde. Indoor air quality is an incredibly complex problem to understand. Over 30 years, we've been relentlessly pursuing our understanding of that, and it continues to grow every single day. So other sensors, such as this one here, are gel-based. What that means is the minute they're manufactured, they start to dry out. And over time, the numbers they start feeding back to you become inaccurate. This orange here absolutely does not have any formaldehyde in it whatsoever, but this sensor will tell you that it does. Our sensor uses a solid state system that's continuously monitoring what's happening in the air in your home. But it's not enough to know what's just happening in your room. We need to do something about it. Inside this, we have a material that's been coated with a catalytic substance. It's based on a material called cryptomeline. And so at an atomic level, it has these really tiny tunnels, which are perfectly shaped in size to allow the formaldehyde to pass through. But as it's passing through, manganese in the filter breaks down that formaldehyde into carbon dioxide and water, which is harmless. So our formaldehyde filter doesn't just capture formaldehyde, but it actually destroys it, which is much more important for people in their homes.